Good afternoon and good morning, respected chairpersons and jury members and all my delegates and colleagues present at the conference. Myself, Dr. Pankti, and I'll be also speaking for my co-authors, Dr. Swati and Dr. Neelkamal. I am currently PG Semester 1 MSc Forensic Odontology student at NFSU Gandhinagar. And the topic on which I will be presenting is stereo microscopy, a useful method for dental profiling. Now, Jock Longino is one of a very reputed entomologist, and he once quoted that if you are shopping for a home entertainment system, then you cannot do better than a good dissecting microscope. And I totally agree with that. And we shall be seeing in the further slides why so. So this is actually a review article which was done using keyword search on Google Scholar and PubMed regarding dental profiling methods, techniques which are used in dental profiling, age estimation, sex determination, and ancestry study. And focusing only on the articles which used stereo microscopy as a tool, we shortlisted 17 articles which formed the base of our review paper. Now, stereo microscope is actually an optical microscope which will observe and see a 3D view of a specimen. Unlike a compound microscope, it works on reflected light rather than light which is transmitted through the body. And a magnification range, an average would be 4 to 45x, but this is a very conventional thing. Now we also have modern stereo microscopes which give you a magnification ranging from 250 to 400x. And giving you basically a background of what stereo microscopes work on, there were basically two principles on which stereo microscopes. One, the conventional is a green of design, and I would not like to go into the details of that. And the ones which we use now is a CMO design, that is a common main objective. So basically we can divide it into two, fixed power and zoom power. A fixed power offers only a fixed position. And zoom power, you can zoom further in and out as much as you want. Now, use of stereo microscopy in dental profiling. So the study of teeth and adjacent dental tissues in the oral cavity for the purpose of estimating the victim's identity is called as dental profiling. It comprises a group of more or less specific characteristics relating to the oral cavity of and in and around the teeth. Now, why is dental profiling important, and why I choose this as my topic is because sometimes circumstantial evidence may not be present or it cannot give the identity of a victim. So the role of a forensic odontologist being is to establish a relationship or identity in the case where antemortem records are not present. And this information which is obtained will enable a more focused search for the antemortem records, or if not available, it will surely give a very strong lead in the investigation. Apart from this, dental profiling also includes analysis of certain characteristics like your personal and dietary habits, oral dental health, the socioeconomic status. So basically a triad of information which will give you information of your ethnicity, sex, and age. Now, focusing on the use of stereo microscopic studies which are done for ancestry determination, we could not found a more number of articles specifically targeting to ancestry determination. There were only two studies which were done. And since stereo microscope is a very good tool, or it is a potential tool which is used to view opaque, thick and solid objects and surfaces, this is a very useful technique which we can use for determination of the non-metric dental traits, that are the morphological features which are present in the tooth. A lot of morphological traits can directly relate the sample, or you can also view the cast And it can directly correlate this information about the ancestry of the person, the missing person or the victim. Next, speaking about the sex, there are a lot of studies done from a clinical point of view. Most of the studies which were directly oriented toward forensic aspect, we found 17 studies specifically using stereo microscope, which were aiming towards sex determination. Out of which I would like to mention that the most accurate success rate which was determined was 89%, which was conducted by Fazal Shaheed et al. In 2015. They actually used geomorphometric analysis of tooth measuring the mesiodistal and buccal-equal dimensions. And using that, they could distinguish the sex based on the canine dimorphism. They also tested the same theory for the distal accessory ridge and the incisor index. But the concluding remark again said that a more larger sample size and a more standard guideline would be needed for this. A lot of studies have also been done using stereo microscope for age determination. As you can see in the slide, I have listed five studies which were comparing stereo microscopes with the different techniques. So Cassetti et al. Compared the polarized light microscope and stereo microscope, and they found that both of them could give a good amount of result based on accuracy, which were close to the actual age. There were studies which were based on apical dentine translucency, and one of the most popular was the Johnson and Lamedon method, in which they used the stereo microscope and also the dental vernier caliper, and they could found a strong relation to the actual age when they compared it to the morphological features. Bharadwaj et al. Also used a similar method adopted from the Johnson, but in his study, the regressive analysis showed that digital method was more prominent than later being the convention and least being the stereo microscopic. So as you can see, there are a lot of varying results which were found when stereo microscopy was used for age determination. So now while reviewing the paper, we found that there were a lot of research gaps in terms of sample selection, in terms of the inclusion criteria for the samples or the cast, and the methods which were used for age and sex determination. So it also caught my interest to look deeper and understand stereo microscope in depth. So stereo microscopes which were used conventional have been updated to a lot of recent advances now. So I would like to highlight some of them, which will be useful for a forensic odontologist. First is that large zoom range. Now, large zoom range means that now when I'm explaining the technical terms, I would be explaining how that is useful to us. So when I say large zoom range, stereo microscope now also have auxiliary attachments for the objective. So what this does is that it allows us to magnify the zoom range. So if you are using a conventional stereo microscope, you can attach the auxiliary lenses and you can increase the magnification. Apart from that, it also has a coherent contrast. This means that the sample you are viewing will be illuminated in a direction that is the light coming from beneath the platform as well as above, and also a diagonal direction. So this will give contrast if you are using transparent samples or you are using the transparent slice of the teeth. And the most recent advantage is the fluorescence ready Nikon stereo microscopes which are available. Now this can be useful especially for bite mark analysis. Because if we have bite marks which are directly present on a solid surface, or we have indentation, incisal indentations, this can be very much appreciated using fluorescence light. It can be viewed using your infrared and UV light, which can be directly incorporated if you have a stereo microscope, which allows you to use a fluorescence light. Some of the advantages which I would like to mention is that opaque objects can be studied under stereo microscope with the use of transmitted light, and even translucent specimens can be used using ultraviolet light. So stereo microscope will help us for dual purposes. Apart from the solid objects, we can also use translucent or your thin cut slices of the tooth in case if we need it. Now, photography is one of the important aspects when we considered in case reporting. And for photography, you just need to attach a ring flash and you're good to go. And the photographs which are obtained are clear, shadowless, and it also can be acceptable in the court of law. Enlarged focus and focus stacking, for people who would not understand what is focus stacking is when you click multiple images of a single picture and then you stack the image up so that you get a clear depth of field. So now, instead of having expensive cameras, all you can do is you can use normal DSLR and you can click different photographs at different levels. Like if you're making the slicing of the tooth, you can take multiple photographs and then you can stack it up and you can also get a better clear view of the photo. Better ergonomics and working efficiency, as a stereo microscope is a dissecting microscope. It also allows you to work in a time-consuming way. I would say it is more handy, and you do not need to prepare a slide, which you would have to do if you're using a compound microscope. And a control zoom focus means that you would be easily able to set up your sample once and then you are done. All you have to do is manipulate the zoom focuses rather than changing the entire platform setup. And dual illumination means, as I explained above, the light sources, you can have multiple light sources and you can also attach a light source if you need. Going through the articles, I also found that stereo microscope has been used in other studies also. That was to observe the study, the enamel prints and the lip prints present on the hard subjects. It has also been used in anthropology to study the macrovair, the surface alteration on the bones to differentiate between the heart trauma and the blunt trauma. It has also been used to study skull trauma injuries. Stereo microscope can also be helpful in studying charred remains and Dalton remains, which are very difficult to handle as they're prone to getting fragmented. And effects of elevated temperature on the restorative materials is also one of the area of interest which can use stereo microscope. Latest articles also present data about using stereo microscope in gross study dissections, which can be a very useful tool for oral autopsies before transferring or before contaminating or before slicing the sample. You can at least have a gross or visual examination under a stereo microscope, and then you can expose that sample or evidence to sectioning, and then you can move forward to viewing it under a compound microscope. So stereo microscope is actually a very handy lab instrument. It is easy to use, and it requires minimum preparation, and it also occupies a very limited space. And with recent advances happening in stereo microscope, our further goals of our study would be validating the methods which have been already done by the previous articles, and comparing the same method using stereo microscope and other scopes. And we would also try to bridge the research gaps which we found in the studies. And along with that, examination of hard and soft tissues, examination of dental cast, examination of your soft tissue. This all entirely builds up a dental profile, and dental profiling is very much important when it comes to identification of a victim when antemortem records are not present. So I would like by concluding that stereomicroscopy is a very useful tool in forensic odontology, especially for dental profiling. Thank you.